A king had a daughter unequaled for beauty, but she thought so much of herself that no suitor was good enough for her.
The Princess Elena has arrived!
She's here!
Well, well, my dear daughter Elena has arrived at last. Many fine kings have come to ask for your hand in marriage. Surely you will find one of them acceptable. They are superior gentlemen, one and all. You may choose one to live happily ever after with.
Oh, Father, really? You don't mean to tell me these are the cream of the crop?
Eh?
I am much too superior for this lot. I wish that you had not invited them here in the first place.
Did you hear that?
Elena, I cannot allow you to be so insulting.
Princess, if I may, I am King Franz of Golder at your service, ma'am.
But of course, Golder, you have famine there. But I never imagined even the king would look starved as a shriveled branch.
A shriveled branch?
Ma'am, I'm the Royal Highness King Turner from Turnerland, ma'am.
Really, Father, do you mean to tell me that you would have your only daughter become the wife of a beer barrel?
A beer barrel, ma'am?
Elena, your behavior is very embarrassing.
If my behavior is so embarrassing, perhaps you'd better send them all away. They're all impossible, you see.
Oof.
Princess, I am King Feral.
How much you resemble a horse that pulls a cart.
Huh?
my, a real lion. Great big grasshopper. Upon my word, this one resembles nothing so much as a defeated bulldog.
Hmm? Bulldog? This has gone far enough.
Well, how terribly dressed you are. And besides that, that ridiculous grizzled little beard of yours reminds me of a bird's beak. I shall therefore call you Young King Grizzlebeard.
I have heard all that I intend to hear, daughter. Are you truly unable to judge people by anything other than their appearance? Nothing but their looks, their fortunes, the size of their kingdoms? From now on, I shall no longer tolerate your superior attitude and impossible vanity. Listen to me. Out of the suitors who next come to this castle, I am going to make the one with the lowest status your husband. Do you understand? The next one to come to the castle.
But Father... Father, wait!
Elena had never seen her father as angry as he was that day. She left the reception and locked herself in her room with her ladies-in-waiting to ponder what fate might have in store for her. She was growing weary with her anxiety when suddenly she heard music outside her window.
My maiden fair, my darling.
Pretty princess, would you let a poor musician sing to you?
Oh, my. What a shabby-looking fellow.
You! Huh? There! Huh? Musician!
Yes?
The king's called for you!
Glory be, the king!
Oh, it mustn't be! It's impossible! Father!
Oh, you're just in time, Elena.
Your Majesty, was it the royal intention that you were going to do me a favor?
Because I like your song and the way you sang it so much, I've decided to give you my daughter as your bride.
The princess is my bride, Your Highness?
I'm not going to do it. I'll never wed such a shabby man.
I made you a promise, and I'm going to keep it. This is the next man to come along, and he certainly has a very low status.
No, I can't believe you're doing this to me. Please, Father.
Since you are now the musician's wife, it is your duty to be with your husband. You can no longer stay here in the castle. You must now begin your new life. I hope you will be very happy.
Father! Oh!
And so Elena and the musician were married. They prepared to leave for the musician's home, but not until he had sold all of Elena's possessions.
Well, we've certainly got a problem. It was all I could manage just to stay alive myself.
Would you mind telling me where you've parked your carriage?
If I were rich enough to have a carriage, food wouldn't be any problem. What do you think your legs are for, anyway?
I'll thank thank you not to talk to me in that manner. Use that money you got from selling my dress to hire a carriage. I shall wait right here until then.
But you are my wife. You must come along.
Oh, please, do not come near me.
Huh?
I'll sit on this rock and wait.
If you would like.
Are you just going to stand there while I'm eaten by this wild animal?
Next time you'll listen when I tell you to keep walking.
What a perfectly beautiful forest. I wonder who owns it. Would you happen to know?
This all belongs to a king called Grizzlebeard. He owns this land as far as the eye can see. It would have been yours had you married into his family.
This splendid forest belongs to King Grizzlebeard, the one who is dressed so terribly? I don't believe it. Oh, look. What about these beautiful golden fields of wheat? Who do they belong to, musician?
It all belongs to the king as far as the eye can see. That's King Grizzlebeard's family castle right over there.
And a marvelous castle it is. Musician! How far are you going, for goodness sake? I said musician!
Listen to me! Stop using that tone of voice. I am not your servant, and don't you dare forget it. We are husband and wife, whether you like it or not. That's my modest cottage right over there. You see it?
Modest is hardly the word. Oh, I cannot believe that you would actually ask a princess to live in such a tiny, rundown cottage.
Be quiet. From now on, the only thing that you are a princess of is my home, young lady. And this is it. Please remember that a man's home is his castle. Enter.
Musician, where are the servants?
There are no servants here, wife. From this day forward, anything at all that you want done, you are just going to have to do yourself. Your first duty is to light the fire and prepare me something to eat.
I will not. You cook. I'm leaving.
I forgot to tell you, there's a ferocious wolf out there. But if you're not afraid of wolves, just go ahead and leave.
Make a fire, cook a meal, you say? Well, I don't know how. I wasn't trained for that kind of work.
Yes. Well, you better pay attention while I teach you how. Now watch carefully. Why are you wasting time standing there watching the fire? While the food's cooking, start weaving a basket.
Me weave a basket? Why in the world would I ever weave a basket?
Simple. The baskets you weave, we sell in town. From those sales, we earn money. And with that money, we are able to eat. If you don't work, you can't eat. Watch. Here's how it's done. There. Now you do the rest of it. I have some business to do in town, so you continue while I'm gone. And remember, only those who work get food to eat. Work. Why are you not hard at work? You've been standing there all this while? Why? Why weren't you weaving the basket?
Oh, and the fire's gone out, and the food is only half cooked. Surely you can't be that helpless.
I'm unable to work with my hands.
That means you are unable to eat.
It's my business whether I eat or not.
If you don't eat, you'll starve.
Better that I should starve than live in such misery.
That is a very foolish attitude. But if that's the way you feel, good riddance to you. Please don't cry. I didn't mean what I said. I went out and bought some pottery with the money I got from selling your dress. You can go to the market tomorrow and sell it. You don't have to do anything but sit there.
Musician, if I go and sit in that market, I'll meet someone from my father's kingdom. I know there are many who would laugh at the sight and think it hilarious. I can't do it. I just can't be made fun of.
Then we're back to basket weaving.
I'll go to the market then.
Is there any way that I can help you? I'll make room for you. You can set up shop next to mine. Many people pass this way. You sell your wares easily.
We help each other. Here, sit by me. You're a pretty girl. Hungry, dear? We don't have much, but we can offer you something.
We're trying to help newcomers. Because we...
I don't need any help. I can take care of myself. Thank you.
I am really fed up with the youth of today. They treat everyone so terribly.
I'll never be able to sell anything. This is so embarrassing. What if I run into someone I know?
Goodness, what a beautiful young lady you are. May I buy something from you? What's the price of this?
I don't know.
Well, how about this? Will this pay for it? Well, maybe I could dig a little deeper down. Here.
I'm most grateful.
My pleasure.
Dear, what a truly beautiful young girl you are. I'll buy that small plate from you.
Yes.
Miss, I'll buy that expensive-looking vase.
Oh, I'm amazed.
I'd sure like to buy that large blue plate.
How much is this?
I'll take these.
I'll take this.
I'm so pleased to be of service. Thank
Here,
you.
Take the money.
Thank you.
This is what I want.
Oh, my. It's so easy. Everyone wants to buy from me because I'm a beautiful princess. How nice to have your best qualities recognized. That awful musician is going to get a big surprise. Broken. That man on horseback was a monster.
Foolish girl. You didn't use your head, did you, setting up your wares at the very edge of the market street? And you're surprised at what happened?
But I'm not the one whom you should blame. It was that soldier.
It's always someone else. Why did you not set out your pottery where all the others were? Would you mind very much explaining that to me? I'm all ears. Let's hear it. Why'd you do it, Princess?
They all look so dirty. I didn't want to be near them.
Listen here. In order to live, people have to depend on each other and work together. That is the way the world is. My hope is that you will do a lot better in your next job, for tomorrow morning you will commence work in the castle kitchen.
The castle kitchen?
You'll be carrying water and learning to mop. And you'd better work hard and do exactly as you're told, otherwise you won't even be given table scraps to eat.
Table scraps are not in my diet.
There'll be nothing in your diet if you don't change your ways and learn to work hard.
Elena found herself having to work harder than she ever had before. She was hungry and tired and beginning to weaken.
Oh, what do you think you're doing? If you want to eat, you have to work properly.
I know it must be hard for you to have to work all day, but everyone's the same. She fainted.
Fainted? What is it, eh? What's the matter, child? Pull yourself together.
Poor little thing.
What a relief she's come to.
You'll be all right, but you'd better rest for a while.
I will draw and carry the water for you.
But that is my work as the water carrier.
Listen, whether you're the water carrier or the server or the cook, we all take care of each other around here like we're all one family.
All the same family?
I'll be glad to draw the water. You'd better serve His Majesty.
Oh, yes, the King.
Why am I standing here when there's work to be done?
Stay right where you are and rest, my dear.
Yes, but...
Really, it's no trouble.
I'm so grateful. Thank you all.
Well, you've got a big appetite today, and I'm glad to see it.
Yes, I'm awfully hungry. Also, if I don't eat properly beforehand, my work in the kitchen becomes a lot harder than I had imagined.
Yes, it's hard work. And tomorrow will be even harder, you know.
Huh?
King Grizzlebeard's wedding ceremony is tomorrow morning, my dearest.
Good King Grizzlebeard is getting married tomorrow.
Well, you're quite full of energy, aren't you? Promise that you'll work hard for me because we're especially busy today.
Yes, sir.
Come and clean the upstairs hall. It needs a good mopping.
All right. Isn't it ever so beautiful? I so wish I could be a part of this. Look at all the beautiful gowns. That's my life as it was, not anymore. A great big grasshopper. I'm much too superior. How amusing. Oh, look, your grizzled beard reminds me of a bird's beak. It was my foolish pride that brought me to this lowly state. I've gotten what I deserved, but at least I've learned how to earn my keep with hard work. Oh my, are you two working here today?
No, I'm here for the wedding ceremony.
Do you mean to tell me that you are one of the invited guests?
No, little princess, the ceremony is for us.
Huh?
Will you be my queen? You'd make me very happy.
I must be in a dream. You're really King Grizzlebeard.
Elena, I wanted to marry you from the first time I saw you. That is why I dressed myself in this costume. And of course, I had already asked your father for his consent. And the soldier who trampled your pottery at the market, that was me too.
Oh my goodness.
I did it all on purpose, hoping it would open your eyes to the foolishness of your pride.
How well you succeeded. I am so very ashamed of my past. It is clear to me now that I am not good enough to be the wife of such a worthy king.
Because of your experience, you have indeed become a better person. Let's forget the past. And now, let the joyous celebration of our royal wedding begin.
Hooray for the princess!
And the lucky king.
Ha 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 ha!
Will you give me your hand in marriage, Elena?